This is Dr. Bev Knox, and you are viewing my psychology tutorials, Learn Psychology While You Sleep.
Although everyday experiences of fear and anxiety are not pleasant, they often are useful. They prepare us for action or fright or flight when danger threatens. They may lead us to drive more cautiously in a storm, keep up with our reading assignments, treat our friends more sensitively, and work harder at our jobs. Unfortunately, some people suffer such disabling fear and anxiety that they cannot lead normal lives. Their discomfort is too severe or too frequent, lasts too long, or is triggered too easily. These people are said to have an anxiety disorder or a related kind of disorder. Anxiety disorders are the most common mental disorders in the United States. In any given year, around 18% of the adult population suffer from one or another type of anxiety disorder, while close to 29% of all people developed one of the disorders at some point in their lives. So now, let us review the different types of anxiety disorders. People with generalized anxiety disorder experience excessive anxiety and worry about a wide range of events and activities. According to the sociocultural view, societal dangers, economic stress, or related racial and cultural pressures may create a climate in which cases of generalized anxiety disorder are more likely to develop. In the original psychodynamic explanation, Freud said that generalized anxiety disorder may develop when anxiety is excessive and defense mechanisms break down and function poorly. Psychodynamic therapists use free association, interpretation, and related psychodynamic techniques to help people overcome this problem. Carl Rogers, the leading humanistic theorist, believed that people with generalized anxiety disorder fail to receive unconditional positive regard from significant others during their early childhood, and so become overly critical of themselves. He treated such individuals with client-centered therapy. Cognitive behavioral therapists believe that generalized anxiety disorders is caused by various maladaptive assumptions and inaccurate beliefs about the power and value of worrying. Cognitive behavioral therapists help their clients to change their maladaptive thinking and/or dysfunctional uses of worrying. Biological theorists hold that generalized anxiety disorder results from a hyperactive fear circuit, the brain circuit consisting of several brain structures. Common biological treatments are antidepressant drugs, benzos, and antipsychotic drugs. A phobia is a severe, persistent, and unreasonable fear of a particular object, activity, or situation. The two main categories of phobias are specific phobias and agoraphobia. Cognitive behavioral therapists believe that phobias are often learned from the environment. Through classical conditioning or modeling and maintained by avoidance behaviors. Specific phobias have been treated most successfully with exposure techniques, cognitive behavioral approaches in which people confront the object they fear. The exposures may be gradual and relaxed, which is known as desensitization, or intense, which is known as flooding, or observed, which is modeling. Agoraphobia is also treated effectively by exposure therapy. People with social anxiety disorder experience severe and persistent anxiety about social or performance situations in which they may be scrutinized by others or be embarrassed. Therapists who treat social anxiety disorder typically distinguish two components of this disorder: social fears and poor social skills. They try to reduce social fears by drug therapy and/or cognitive behavioral therapy, including exposure techniques. And they try to improve social skills by social skills training. Panic attacks are periodic, discrete bouts of panic that occur suddenly. Sufferers of panic disorder experience panic attacks repeatedly and unexpectedly without apparent reason. Panic disorder may be accompanied by agoraphobia in some cases, leading to two diagnoses. Many biological theorists believe that panic disorder is caused by a hyperactive panic circuit, a brain circuit that includes structures such as the amygdala, hippocampus, and central gray matter. Biological therapists use certain antidepressant drugs or benzos to treat people with this disorder. Cognitive behavioral therapists suggest that panic-prone people become preoccupied with some of their bodily sensations, misinterpret them as signs of medical catastrophe, have panic attacks, learn to display avoidance and safety behaviors that help control their bodily sensations, and in some cases, develop panic disorder. Cognitive behavioral therapists teach clients to interpret their physical sensations more accurately and to cope better with anxiety. People with obsessive compulsive disorder are beset by obsessions, perform compulsions, or both. Compulsions are often a response to a person's obsessive thoughts. So the obsession, which is the obsessive, the O in OCD, is the thoughts. And the compulsion, which is the compulsive part of the OCD, the C part, is the action or the behavior. So in OCD, O is the thought, C is the compulsion or the action that neutralizes the thought. According to the psychodynamic view, obsessive compulsive disorder arises out of a battle between id impulses and ego defense mechanisms. In contrast, cognitive behavioral therapists believe that the disorder grows from a normal human tendency to have unwanted and unpleasant thoughts. The efforts of some people to understand, eliminate, or avoid such thoughts actually lead to obsessions and compulsions. Cognitive behavioral therapists educate clients and help them correct their misinterpretations of the unwanted thoughts. With such gains in hand, the therapists then conduct exposure and response prevention. Antidepressant drugs that raise serotonin activity are a widely used and useful form of treatment. In addition to OCD, the DSM-5 lists a group of obsessive-compulsive related disorders, disorders in which obsessive-like concerns drive individuals to repeatedly and excessively perform specific patterns of behavior that greatly disrupt their lives. This group consists of hoarding disorder as well as body dysmorphic disorder. To explain anxiety, obsessive compulsive, and related disorders, proponents of the developmental psychopathology perspective examine how key factors emerge and intersect at points throughout an individual's lifespan. The factors of interest to them include genetic factors, a hyperactive fear circuit in the brain, parenting style, maladaptive thinking, avoidance behaviors, life stress, and negative social factors.